हेलो हेलो,
गुड आफ्टरनून सर।
गुड आफ्टरनून। अटेंडेंस मार्क कर लो सब लोग। What was my last point of discussion? Can anyone say what was my last point of discussion? Okay. I think I have completed various tests on aggregates, tests on aggregates. I think I have discussed various tests on aggregate. First one is your crushing strength. First one is your crushing strength. Crushing strength test. One test is only left for your test on aggregate, which I discussed in today's session. So crushing strength, first one is your crushing strength. Second one is your, I think, impact test. Second one is your impact test. Impact test. Second one is your impact test. Third one is your hardness test. Third one is your hardness test. Fourth one is your, I think last one is your shape test, okay? Amit?
Yes, sir.
Last one is your shape test?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, I think I have completed these four tests. First one is your crushing strength test. Second one is your impact test. third one is your hardness test, fourth one is your shape test, and today I completed. After today's session, I complete this test also, soundness test. Soundness test. Soundness test. So basically, these are five type of test which we perform on our aggregate. You already know what are aggregates. There are two type of aggregate. One is coarse aggregate and another is fine aggregate. How we use coarse aggregate? We use coarse aggregate to generate or to prepare concrete. So in last class, I think I already discussed how the property of concrete will be governed by the property of your aggregate. Basically, the property of aggregate or the property of concrete, such as strength and also workability, will be governed by the property of your aggregate. And such a property which govern the property of concrete is your shape test of your aggregate. Basically, aggregate have four shape. I already discussed these things. So can anyone say? Or I think I want Dharani. Dharani.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Can you repeat this test, shape test, from your side? How we perform shape test?
Yes, sir.
Okay. If you want, you also speak in Hindi. So.
Okay.
You start from your side. So.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. सर सेफ टेस्ट पहले हम लोग टेस्ट कर सेफ टेस्ट में हम लोग चार टाइप का सेफ देखते हैं सर. पहला राउंड एग्रीगेट होता है, दूसरा एंगुलर एग्रीगेट होता है, तीसरा फ्लकी एग्रीगेट होता है, और चौथा एलोंगेटेड होता है. जो राउंडनेस होता है हम टेस्ट करते हैं कि वो एग्रीगेट राउंड कितना, रहा है कैसा, रिएक्शन कैसा दे रहा है, ये सारा टेस्ट करते हैं राउंड एग्रीगेट पे. और राउंडनेस एग्रीगेट टेस्ट होता है सर, वो एक स्केल होता है सर, जिसमें हम लोग 0 to 11 तक उसमें इंडिकेट करते हैं, जिसमें 33 to 44% तक होता है. जिसमें अगर जैसे 33 आया तो वो राउंड एग्रीगेट है 33, और जैसे 11 तक जाएगा तो वो 44 पे चला जाता है, तो 44 पे तो वो उतना एंगुलर एग्रीगेट में चला जाता है सर. फिर
एक चीज धारणी
yes, sir.
तुम बता रहे हो कि सर 33 to 44% तक जाता है, ये क्या जाता है तुम्हारा? यू से कि सर आई थिंक परसेंटेज वॉल्यूम ऑफ वर्ड्स जाता है, नॉट वर्ड्स, इट इज परसेंटेज वॉल्यूम ऑफ वर्ड्स. ओके
सर, परसेंटेज.
ओके सो यू करेक्ट. ओके सो you correct this thing from your side, and the percentage volume of void is from 33 to 44. Yes,
yes,
so
sir.
So you say right, sir, our percentage volume of void is from the scale of 33 to 34, and also above on this scale we write our angularity number, and angularity number will vary from 0 to 11,
sir.
Okay. Yes, sir. Okay. Proceed. Okay. Proceed from your side.
उसके बाद सर हम लोग पढ़े थे फ्लकी इंडेक्स पढ़े थे, और फ्लकी इंडेक्स को हम लोग मेजर करते हैं थिकनेस गेज के हिसाब से सर. अगर हम लोग का 0.6 इंटू मीन डायमेंशन अगर रहा ना, तो वो रेंज में हम लोग का आ जाए. उससे हम लोग फ्लकी इंडेक्स चेक करते हैं, उसका रेंज नॉट मिनिमम 6.3 mm होता है सर, और उसमें 15% से ज्यादा नहीं लिया जाता है सर. उसके बाद फिर हम लोग पढ़े थे ये elongation test पढ़े थे. elongation test को हम लोग length gauge के हिसाब से measure करते हैं. और सर test भी explain करना है.
हाँ बताओ, जो भी पता है तुमको बताओ.
Yes sir. तो पहले हम लोग sieve लेते हैं. sieve चार पांच size का ले लेते हैं, जैसे कि 20 mm.
अभी तुम flaking इंडेक्स का भी टेस्ट तुम गलत बताई हो. अगर उसको भी तुमको पता है तो रिपीट करो, नहीं तो फिर हम दूसरे से पूछते हैं. फ्लैकिनेस इंडेक्स का भी तुम टेस्ट वो सही से नहीं बता पाई. अगर तुमको पता है तो बताओ कैसे टेस्ट कंप्लीट करते हैं.
यस सर. पहले हम लोग लेते हैं 200 पीस ऑफ एग्रीगेट ले लेते हैं. नहीं पहले ये लेते हैं, सीव लेते हैं सर. उसके बाद उसको सीविंग कर लेते हैं. और हर सीविंग में हम लोग का ना 200 पार्टिकल्स एग्रीगेट का आना चाहिए. उसके बाद हम लोग एक एक करके उसमें से थिकनेस गेज में से पास करते हैं सर. और थिकनेस गेज में से पास करने के बाद फिर हम लोग मेजरमेंट कर लेते हैं सर. ये कैलकुलेशन करते हैं 3/5 ऑफ मीन डायमेंशन करके उसका कैलकुलेशन, ओवरऑल कैलकुलेशन मेजरमेंट करते हैं सर. और फ्लैकिंग इंडेक्स नॉट मोर देन 15% होना चाहिए सर. और फिर सेम प्रोसीजर रहता है सर. ये इलोंगेशन इंडेक्स का भी वही सेम प्रोसीजर रहता है कि हम लोग पहले सीविंग कर लेते हैं और उसके बाद फिर हर सीव पे 200 एग्रीगेट जो होता है वो रिटेन करना चाहिए. उसके बाद एक एक करके हम लोग लेंथ गेज से पास कर लेते हैं. और उसके बाद हम लोग लेते हैं इसमें ग्रेटर डायमेंशन ऑफ ग्रेटर 1.8 mm ऑफ मीन डायमेंशन सर इसमें ले लेते हैं. और उसके बाद फिर कैलकुलेशन कर लेते हैं. और हम लोग का IRC कहता है कि नॉट ग्रेटर देन 30% होना चाहिए सर.
नॉट ग्रेटर देन 50%.
और ऐसे हम लोग 15%
ऑल्सो नॉट ग्रेटर देन
15% यस सर. ऐसे हम लोग 15% यस सर. ऐसे हम लोग 15% भी नॉट ग्रेटर देन 15% भी अप्लाइड करते हैं. बट हम लोग IRC कहता है कि नॉट ग्रेटर देन 30%. और ये भी टेस्ट हम लोग 6.3 mm से ग्रेटर डायमेंशन के पार्टिकल्स के लिए करते हैं सर.
ओके गुड. आई थिंक यू एक्सप्लेन इन बेटर मैनर. सो आई सेटिस्फाइड विथ योर आंसर. गुड. सो आई थिंक सेप टेस्ट इज कम्प्लीटेड. I think Dharni say, yes, sir, you already discussed there are four shape of aggregate. First is your rounded, second is your angular shape, third is flaky, and next is elongated. So there are four shapes of aggregate: rounded, angular, flaky, and elongated. I already discussed how we find roundness and angularity of a aggregate. Basically, we use angular number. Here angular number is written. So Amit Kumar Pramanik.
Yes sir.
Host bana do humko. Dekho tum host ho gaya ho. Okay. So I think Dhani say, ki sir, we use angularity number to check roundness and angularity of an aggregate. Basically, angularity number given on a scale from 0 to 11, and also for checking roundness and angularity of an aggregate, we use percentage volume of void concept. Basically, percentage volume of void lies in the range of 33 to 44. So generally we use this percentage volume of void for checking our roundness and angularity of a aggregate. Now I already discussed about your flakiness test and also elongation test. Basically flaky particles are those particles whose least dimension, I already discussed, whose minimum dimension is 0.6 times of 0.6 times of mean dimension. Least dimension is 0.6 times of your mean dimension. So basically those particle whose least dimension is less than 0.6 times of mean dimension. So in last class I take this aggregate and also mark the length of aggregate as something 12 meter or 10 meter, 10 mm. Also width as 8 mm. Also I mark height or depth or thickness as 1 mm. So when we take mean dimension means length plus breadth plus height by 3. So we get the dimension, this dimension after this calculation less than 1 mm. Less than 1 mm. So we call this particle as flaky particles. So for flaky particle, we required flakiness index. For checking flakiness index, we required flakiness index test. For flakiness index test, first we take our sieves. Then we arrange our sieves in decreasing order. We put our sieve, top sieve, whose size is 63 mm on top, and arrange all the sieve in decreasing order. So basically here is our 63 mm sieve. Now from top to bottom we decrease the size of sieve. So generally on bottom we use the sieve which size is 6.3 mm. We take the aggregate particles. We take the aggregate particle from here. Our aggregate particles are present. From here, we take our aggregate particles. We take our aggregate particles. From here, we take our aggregate particles and put on the sieves and start shaking the sieves. Then some of aggregate will left on this sieve. So minimum 200 number of aggregate will be available on each fraction of sieve. So basically from 63 mm to 50 mm, 200 number of aggregate will be retained. From 50 to 41.5 mm, also 200 number of aggregates will be retained. So we separate out the 200 number of aggregates and pass these aggregates from our which gauge? Can anyone say from which gauge we pass these 200 number of aggregates? From thickness gauge or length gauge?
Thickness gauge.
Okay.
Thickness gauge, sir.
Okay. From thickness gauge, we pass this 200 number of aggregate for checking our flakiness of aggregate. So basically, these 200 number of aggregates will be passing from the slots of our thickness gauge. The aggregate which is passing from these slots will be taken separately. So here the aggregate which is passed from these slots will be taken out, and then we weight this aggregate. So basically we weight this aggregate. The weight comes out to be W2. Now here 200 number of aggregate present on one fraction, also 200 number of aggregate present on another fraction, also 200 number of aggregate present on another fraction. So basically we add all the weights of 200 number of aggregates. So basically that weights become from one fraction, weight from one fraction, weight from here also we write weight from another fraction. So here we get W1. So if we divide this W2 with W1, what we found? What we found? I think we found flakiness index value. Our IRC says this flakiness index value should not be more than 15% for your construction of pavement, that means construction of concrete. Now next is your, I think next is your elongation index test. Elongation index test, we do same thing. We put all the shapes in decreasing order. On top we put 63 mm and here we put 50 mm. Here we put 41.5 mm. Then down we put 31.5 mm and so on. Bottom we put 6.3 mm. Basically, I also write or I also discuss one note point that minimum size of sieve which is used for flakiness index testing or elongation index testing is 6.3 mm sieve. So basically, the aggregate whose size is smaller than 6.3 mm, we do not use that type of aggregate for flakiness or elongation index testing. So basically, for I think I already discussed these things, for checking elongation index, we called a particle as elongated aggregate or elongated particle whose size is greater than 1.8 times of mean dimension. So these two questions ask in your many state PSC, that means State Public Service Commission, also in GATE examination and also in your SSC JE examination, that is if 1.8 into mean dimension is given, the size is elongated aggregate. Next one is your flaky. Third one is your both hand A and B, and next one is your none of these. So basically, if in question they give 1.8 into mean dimension, which aggregate which greater dimension is greater than 1.8 time of mean dimension, then the particle is elongated particle. If an aggregate is called as flaky aggregate if its least dimension or minimum dimension is 0.6 times of mean dimension, then that aggregate is called as your flaky aggregate. So basically, this question asked in your many examination. So just remember these two points: 0.6 into mean dimension, and next one is 1.8 into mean dimension. Basically, you have to remember these things also. That is your thickness gauge is used for checking your flakiness index testing, and length gauge is used for your checking of elongated particle or elongation index testing. We generally require length gauge. So basically, these two or three points will be asked in many times in your state PSC or your SSC JE GATE examination, and also in ESC objective questions. So basically, you by heart this point also. So it is okay to everyone. I think up to this, it is okay to everyone. Can I proceed?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So just remember this point.
Yes, sir.
I already discuss these things. Again, I write this thing in 3 or 4.
Sir, आपका voice echo कर रहा है.
Okay. Just wait. Shape test is very, very important. Rohit?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I think. Ab theek hai, Rohit?
Yes, sir.
Okay. जस्ट रिमेम्बर दिस थिंग, सेफ टेस्ट इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. आई राइट दिस थिंग बिकॉज यू रिमेम्बर फ्रॉम योर साइड. यस सर, ऑल्सो राइट. Only safe test is very very important because in many examination many question ask only from your safe test. So by heart this test, because in this test many technical I think aspects will be involved from concrete side also, like your strength of concrete, workability of concrete, and also many more technical aspects for your aggregate is also involved. So I think everything is clear up to this test. That means for crushing test I already discussed all thing, for impact test I already discussed all things, for your hardness test I already discussed all things, for your shape test of aggregate I discussed all thing. So move toward next test. Next test is your soundness test. So just, is it visual to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So basically, Deepa. Deepa. Yes, Deepa. Amit Kumar Pramanik.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Just start the introduction of this test from your side.
Yes, sir. Soundness test introduction. This you test is
first remember this point. Just listen my voice. This test, soundness test, is given as per IS, that means Indian Standard 2386 Part 5. Because I already discussed in many examination, in many examination of engineering service, they give here type 1, that means match 1. Type 1 and type 2. Here they give type 2. Type 1. Here they give type 2. And here they given your crushing strength test. Here they give your crushing strength. Here they give your impact test. Here they give your hardness test. Here they give your shape test. Here they give your soundness test. And also here they give your IS 2386 part 1, part 2, part 3. Part 4, part 5. So must remember this point also, because I also emphasize on this point during your test, that this test is given by Indian Standard 2386 part 5. Because in your building material subject, in your BMC, that means in your building material subject, they ask many times this type of question, that is the seasoning of timber is done from IS 2382, so you have to by heart these things also, that this particular test will be given by IS that number and for that sub part. So you must remember this point also, that soundness test is given as per IS 2386 part 5. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so just start from your side.
Introduction. This test is intended to study the resistance of aggregates to withering action. In order to quicken the effect of withering due to alternative wet-dry and freeze the cycles in the laboratory, the resistance to disintegration of aggregate is determined by soaking the specimen in saturated solution of sodium sulfate or magnesium sulfate.
Okay, stop. Amit, stop from your side. So basically, you all observe here, you all focus here. This test is intended to study the resistance of aggregate to weathering action. So basically, soundness test is done to check the durability, how much our aggregate is durable. So basically, this test is done to check the durability of our aggregate. So basically, I think I already discussed the things, that strength crushing strength test is used to check the strength of our aggregate. Impact test is used to check the toughness of our aggregate. I think I already discussed Los Angeles abrasion test is used to check the hardness of our aggregate. Flakiness index test, angularity number, or your elongation index test. These tests are also used to check the shape of our aggregate. In same manner, soundness test is done to check the durability of our aggregate. So basically, we have to check how our aggregate will be durable. So durability of aggregate. You all absorb this point. As take an example, or take an example that how our soundness impart in aggregate, or how we check soundness test of aggregate. You already know also in Jharkhand monsoon will be coming from I think 10th of June. So most probably from 3 to 4 days, you all feel from your nearby or in your village or in your city, rain is happening, or I think monsoon will be came. So basically, you all travel from your road. So basically, when you travel from your road, you see in rainy season the roads will become deteriorated, or in many places many spots.
Sir, आपका voice ठीक से नहीं आ रहा.
Okay, just wait. I am in college. I think your college will be reopened. So I am in college. So in college, some network issue will be available or present.
Sir, now okay.
Okay. So basically, when you travel from the road during this time, when you travel from the road, you see many spots or many holes or many big, many big crackings, or on a certain places muddy water is also present on your road. So basically, this all happens because of less durability of aggregate. So basically, we have to check how much our aggregate is durable. So to check the durability of our aggregate, we use this test. So basically, we use our soundness test of aggregate. This test is used to check the resistance of aggregate to weathering action. Weathering action may be anything. It may be your rainy, it may be your temperature rising case, it may be your higher humidity case. So weathering action may be anything. I think you already discussed in soil mechanics weathering action of rock. Weathering action will be formed by wind. Weathering action will be formed by your running water. So there are many factors which governs your weathering action. Here we have to check the resistance of aggregate against this weathering action. So in order to quicken the effect of weathering due to alternate wet and dry, so basically these things also happen. Your pavement surface or your road on which vehicles will be moving, they will become wet. That means they will become wet when rain will falling on this road. When rain will falling on this road will become wet. If rain is not falling, then sun is rising, then this pavement will become dry. So this is also another weathering action. Freeze and thawing, that means also this is another kind of your weathering action. Basically, this weathering action will be happen on your road surface with longer span of time. Here, just observe here. Basically, this weathering action, which is happening on your pavement surface, will take more time actually on a pavement. But we want this test done within 2 to 3 days in our laboratory, or maximum time permitted to do this test is maximum 48 hours. So in 48 hours we perform this durability test or this soundness test of aggregate. So basically what we do in this test, in order to quicken the effect of bedding due to alternate wet dry or freeze thaw cycle in the laboratory, the resistance to disintegration of aggregate is determined by soaking the specimen in saturated solution of sodium sulfate or magnesium sulfate. So basically two chemicals, one is your sodium sulfate, another is your magnesium sulfate, is used in this test. How we do this test, or how these chemicals will be used in our test, I discuss these things. Don't worry. The objective of this test is determination of the soundness of aggregate. So basically, from soundness of aggregate, we determine or we check the durability of our aggregate. Apparatus required for this test are containers for aggregate. Basically, we use various containers, or the container we use during this test is wire mesh. Basically, to put this aggregate, we use wire mesh bucket. We generally use wire mesh bucket. We generally use wire mesh bucket. The buckets look like